everybody, thank you so much for clicking on this video. So this is a completely different video than normal because it is my 3-year wedding anniversary. If I'm being honest, this video is happening for two reasons. Number one, I had another video planned for this spot and it just kind of like fell through because it was a terrible, terrible concept. And number two, I want to pay a little homage to my partner, my teammate, my biggest fan, Kevin. We got married 3 years ago. We started dating in 2010, so this is... it's our 12 year, yes, math. This is our 12 year anniversary of being together, 3 years of being married. I should put on my ring. I was working out earlier and I don't like to work out with my rings on, so there we go. So instead of sitting down and
telling you about our partnership, our relationship,
I actually am just gonna put our wedding video in here. It's about 10 minutes long. Unfortunately, the quality isn't great. Hear me out. I had to download it off of Facebook. I'm having trouble getting the original because we didn't pay for our videographers. Really long story short, we couldn't afford it in our budget. We were just gonna have our friends like on their iPhones, like make sure they taped different parts of the night. Like everyone in our party had a different night, part of the night they had to be responsible for. I was like, I have iMovie, I can edit it together. Thank God that didn't happen. Our wedding website was through Wedding Wire, and these like kids from Drexel who were just graduated, they were trying to get into the wedding videography industry. So they were offering their services for free. They found our date on Wedding Wire, they reached out, we made sure it wasn't a scam, and we like signed a contract. And part of the contract was just that we couldn't have the raw footage, we could just have like the wedding video compilation, which I was fine with, because it was free. So anyway, it turned out absolutely fantastic, except for my only qualm, and you're gonna hear it immediately, so I just wanna take ownership that I know I sound like a moron in the beginning of the video. I end everything up, and I'm talking like everything's a question, and it's very annoying, and it only happens for like 2 minutes, and I sound like a doofus. This was before I did YouTube, so I wasn't super comfortable talking in front of a camera yet. So, just had to get that out there. Anyway, without further ado, enjoy our wedding video. So we actually met about 10 years ago. We were both working on a show.
We were in a dinner theater together in Delaware, doing Oklahoma. I remember seeing her, and the first time I ever saw her, because we were in rehearsal, and she like came in a little late, and then like one of the guys like nudged me and was like, "Yeah, yeah." I was like, "Yeah. Pretty cute."
I thought he was cute. He was just really funny, had a great personality. So when we re-met up again a few years later, I still thought he was cute.
We were friendly. We always had really good conversations together. We were good at laughing together. And then just kind of over time, it slowly developed into like more of a romantic thing.
We were talking and I said, you know, we should hang out sometime. And he goes, no, I want to be clear. I want to take you out on a date. I don't want to just hang out with you.
We went on our first like big vacation together. We went on a cruise and we were in St. Martin and took a private boat ride around the island and just spent the whole day hopping in and off the boat. I think that was the best day we've ever had. I think that was the best day of my life. It was just nice that she was there with me and we could share it together.
You know, we didn't get engaged for so long until after we started dating, but it never stressed me out. And we never really even talked about it too much. It was just always, we were always just very present and very happy with where we were.
In my day job, I'm a tour guide, and so I talk to tourists all day. I remember the first time I told a tourist I was thinking about proposing, but I don't remember why I was thinking about that. And then it was a joke like throughout my tours where I would be like, at the end of it, be like, I'm saving up for a ring. And it didn't really become real. And I didn't really know I was actually gonna do it until I told my parents. And then I was like, oh, this feels right. And it just feels so right.
We got engaged in Niagara Falls. And on our way back, we drove and we were just so happy and so like, giddy giggly, not only because we just got engaged, but you know, it's also like the road trip, like giggles and just so many funny things happening on the way back. It was still like one of my favorite moments of us. We snuck a banana back in from Canada, which was exciting.
I don't think life is gonna change very much. I mean, we already live together and we're just gonna be married now. I'm excited.
I think just starting a life together. So I think I'm just excited to have a life and have more adventures together and have our family with our little cat.
Ever since Justina and I were little, we have always planned to be each other's maids of honor at each other's wedding. We made this pact from the day, like when we first started talking about weddings, we always promised each other And now this day is here, and I couldn't be happier for both of you. I absolutely loved growing up with a sister so close in age. We are only 13 months apart. And you would think that sisters so close in age would be at each other's necks all the time. And we have had our fair share of arguments, but for the most part, we have always been best friends and partners in crime. We had a great childhood with amazing, loving parents. But despite all that, we would frequently run away from home. I say that because we would never make it past the corner at the end of our block. But to us, it was a real adventure. We would pack up a backpack with a stuffed animal and maybe a book and always some snacks. And we'd make our way to the corner of Valley View Road. And I'll always remember the one time we got there and we sat right down. And right away, of course, I took out the snack. We only had an apple that day. So immediately I start biting into it. Justina grabs my arm and very seriously looks at me and she says, "Danielle, slow down. That apple has to last us the rest of our lives." Justina has always been the responsible one when it comes to our relationship. And I've always taken on the role of the protector. If someone teased her at school or she was upset about something, I always rushed to her defense. And when she started dating boys, that didn't change. I was the protector. I remember the first night Justina took me to meet Kevin. We went to a bowling alley in New Jersey, and Kevin was performing a set in an open mic night. And I walked in, and I was like, oh, this guy. Didn't give him a chance before I even saw him. And from that first night, seeing them together, I knew it was something that was going to last. Kevin, you are exactly the type of man I've always hoped Justina would spend the rest of her life with. And Justina, you are the most caring, trustworthy, and you radiate beauty inside and out, and I couldn't have asked for a better big sister.
So I guess what my speech has become about today is that there have been three times in my life that Kevin has said something that has affected me literally forever. One, Kevin and I were a part of a performing arts group. It is called the Young Americans. You sing and dance, you travel the world, you don't get paid. It's awful. So Kevin was doing this and he was teaching kids around the world workshops to sing and dance. And I thought this was the most special thing ever. And I wanted to be a part of it, but I was super shy and nervous to try out. And Kevin said to me, "Jay, get over it. The best case scenario when you audition is that he'll say, hey, we need you to go on tour. Welcome to the Young Americans. Or when you audition, he'll say, you know what? Maybe this isn't for you. How bad is that really?" I took that into everything that I did. Like I would look at everything and go, well, what's the best case scenario? What's the worst case scenario? And how bad is it really? The second thing, Kevin came to see me perform one time. And when he came to see me perform, he said, "Jay, I need you to listen to me really closely. Everyone already thinks you're a nice person. You need to show these people why you are an incredible performer. Let go of that humility and do your best." And that affected me in every single audition I've done ever. The third thing that he said to me that affected me for the rest of my life was on Tuesday. I thought that this was gonna be a moment where I could pull Kevin aside and tell him how proud that I am of him recognizing true love and the gift that he really has in Justina. And this would be the third thing that Kevin Hurley said that affected me for the rest of my life. He said, "Dude, it was easy." And that's the thing. When you love someone and you know it should be easy. For as long as I can remember, I've watched the two of you interact, and if there was one thing that wasn't hard, it was for them to get along. If there was one thing that wasn't hard, it was for her to laugh at his jokes. Trust me, that can be really hard sometimes. You know what I'm saying? Like, everything I've ever seen between the two of you guys has just been so easy, and you saying that to me, like, teaches me a lot of things about what to expect in love. Like, love should come easy. So, with that being said, can we all, in solidarity, raise a glass, have a toast, have a smile, have a hug in honor of true love recognizing its counterpoint in one and another. Love you guys.
It's hard for me to remember the 21-year-old Justina that you started dating, but I very distinctly remember the 24-year-old Kevin that I started dating. I remember short hair, which briefly had blonde tips. I remember the insane amount of cream and sugar you put into your morning coffee, and I remember the fruity drinks you had me order on dates for you. But you've definitely changed. Present day Kevin has better hair than me. He drinks black coffee in the morning and prefers a Maker's on the Rocks over an Appletini. We've both changed a lot over the past 8 years. Not necessarily always for the better, but always together. And I think that's the most important thing, growing together as a team. So as your teammate, your partner, your forever adventurer, I promise you three things. Number one, I promise to cherish you no matter how many pairs of underwear never make it to the hamper. I promise to respect you even when I want to kill you. And I promise to stand by your side through hugs and fights, wealth and poverty, success and failure. I'm in for life, and I can't wait to let our adventure continue. You're up, Hurley.
This is crap, because you said I could only have two jokes in mind. And you had like a bunch. Justina, we probably have more inside jokes than any couple in existence. The first conversation we ever had together should not be repeated in these vows, because no one would find it funny but us. Laughter is actually a huge part of my life. Most of the time, laughter is literally my job. No one makes me laugh more than you. You are my best friend. When good things happen to me, I'm more excited to tell you about it than to hear your reaction. One thing we disagree on is the existence of soulmates. You don't happen to believe in them, and I do. So here is my one and only vow to you. I will spend my life trying to prove to you that we are destined to be together. You are the Pam to my Jim. The Lily to my Marshall. We are soup snakes. Adventure continues.
Yeah!